guys, my name is Jacqueline and I wanted to come on here for our 2-month postpartum and baby and mommy update. Sorry if the lighting is not great today. It's like super cloudy outside, but this is Isabella. If you haven't already met her, this little girl had her 2-month checkup yesterday and she is doing great. The doctor said that she is a boss at tummy time. And so that her head control is really, really good. He thought she might be ready for solids at 3 or 4 months, which was like super shocking to me because my son was completely uninterested in food until he was like a year old. 6 months came and went, he never reached for it or anything, but I can see her wanting to grab food sooner. So who knows, maybe at, you know, about 6 months, maybe we will start introducing some baby oatmeal or something like that. Also, this little chunk is 13.8 pounds. So she is the 90th percentile for weight. And then for height, she's the 75th percentile. So she's a little chunky thing. We were comparing her to her cousin last week, and her cousin is 5 months old. And I believe she was 13 pounds. And this little girl is 13.8. And so also a friend of mine, she had her baby, they're like twins, that we were pregnant at the same time and they were born 2 hours apart. And she just saw her on Sunday or Saturday and she's 10 pounds. And again, this little girl, she's almost 14, which makes sense because we moved up. We're out of newborn diapers, out of 1 month diapers. We are in size 2 diapers. And she all week long has been having so many blowouts. So I think it might be time to move up to size 3 because they're just, I don't know. I think it's just the way her little legs are. She's got like 2 giant fat rolls in her, like the upper part of her thigh. So I think that's just kind of making her bump up to the next size diaper, you know, before the, even the weight that they say. So I don't have any pants on her right now. She's just in her little cute onesie here because this poor little baby got her shots yesterday. So she had the oral shot and then also 3 other shots. So it was so sad. I didn't wear any makeup because I knew how much I cried with my son. Of course I cried with this little girl. I just felt like she looked at me like, you're supposed to protect me, you betrayed me. And I just kept telling her, you know, I'm doing this so you don't get more serious stuff. But good thing was the nurse was really, really good. She was super fast. She did all 3 shots and the oral in literally less than 2 minutes. So I was so grateful for that. She's the same one that does my son's shots. So I was happy that I had her. I just noticed. Do you like our matching bows? So yeah, but this little girl, she's doing really good. Sleeping wise, she can sleep some long stretches, just obviously never when I need her to. So her first stretch that she does really good is like 8 to midnight. 8 to midnight, generally, she's a pretty good sleeper. If I could get myself in bed before midnight, that would be ideal. It never happens. That's like, I feel like my life starts at like 8 after I put her down. And so, you know, I'm trying to take a shower, I'm trying to study, I'm trying to clean, so that kind of thing. My husband's home, so I finally want to visit with him. So this little girl, that's her best stretch, but then after that, she's up 3, 5, 7 after that. So it's just kind of tough to still get, you know, a good night's rest. But I mean, that's typical. She's barely 2 months old, so we got a little ways before, you know, her sleep pattern will hopefully level out, you know, for the better. She still loves bath time, never makes a peep, just all little smiles in her little bath. And I'm almost positive she's just starting to teethe. Just these past like 3 days or so, she's drooling, she's grabbing for my hand just like this. Little pretty bow. She's grabbing for my hand, so I think we're gonna have a little teether. We might have to start breaking out those little bandana bibs pretty soon here. Also, speaking of bandana bibs, I wanted to do a video of kind of a use this, not that, you know, like baby mommy edition. So definitely give this video a thumbs up. If you like my mommy videos, if you wanna see more mommy videos, if you wanna see more Isabella, and have Jacob pop in here. So definitely give this video a thumbs up. And please leave in the comments below what other videos you would like to see from me. But that's pretty much all for Isabella. She's still a super messy eater. I get milk all over me all the time. And then as far as I go, weight's still the same. No progress on the weight aspect of it. But I did get a couple new tops and a couple new shorts because I was like of the mindset like, no, I'm not gonna buy anything until I'm the weight that I wanna be. And that was just dumb because all it did was make me feel like it took me forever to get ready because like nothing fits and make me feel bad in what, you know, I was wearing. So now I just got some stuff that fits me, you know, not a ton because I really didn't want, you know, to invest in a bunch of clothes that fit me at this weight because I'm hoping not to be this weight very long. But it just helped me feel better. You know, I got a couple like summer dresses and some you know, cute like off the shoulder stuff that's like super easy to nurse in. Actually, that's another good video idea of like clothes, you know, that are easy to nurse in, you know, outfit ideas for that. But yeah, now I feel so much better. We went out with my family this past weekend for my brother's anniversary, and you know, I felt cute for like the first time in a long time. So so that's with me. As far as any other like postpartum symptoms, I'm not getting the crazy hair loss like I was with my son. That's really, really good. My skin seems to have calmed down. It's like getting some of its moisture back from pregnancy with her. I'm not having, she's really sucking up my hand. You know, I'm not having to like moisturize like crazy, put on so much lip balm and extra stuff. So I feel like my hormones are kind of leveling out from that standpoint. But my emotions are still like haywire. Like I'm still having like some crazy mood swings. Like literally, this morning I was making my coffee and I didn't get to see all of the Bachelorette yesterday. Shh, it's my guilty pleasure. I didn't get to see all the Bachelorette yesterday. And I was like, okay, I'm gonna make my coffee. The kids are sleeping. I'm gonna watch it on, you know, on Hulu on my phone. I'm gonna be really quiet. And I literally wanted to cry. Just the thought of getting to watch my show with my coffee made me want to cry. And generally, that's just not something to cry about. Like, there's real world problems going on. But it just made me so happy at the thought of being able to do that. So I know my emotions are still a little crazy. So give this video a thumbs up if you want to see more of me and Isabelle. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. And I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye.